Hi folks, hope you're well. I'm going to do an ink and watercolour this afternoon, and I've got a week left of my show in New York, and so I thought I would paint a New York inspired scene. Obviously next Thursday's the opening night of my show in London, so I shall be moving on to some London scenes, but for the next couple of days I think I'll be painting some New York stuff. So I'll just set my phone up and see how we get on. I'm going to do it this way up this today because the light's a little bit better that way. I think you can see clearer what I'm up to. So I'm just going to draw a quick sketch out. It's going to be pen and ink and then watercolour. So without any further ado, let's get something down here. I'm into drawing kind of like reflections, and so I'm going to put the Chrysler building here. I just love that building. It's my favourite building in New York. I'm just sketching it out very quickly. Really sort of loose pen strokes. And then this is going to be a window, and so the reflection will be in the window, which is pretty cool. So there's a wall, and then so the Eiffel Tower here, that goes off. So I'm just trying to make sure I'm drawing it out the same height. It's not too bad. So this is the reflection of that. My show in New York, if you're in America now, is on for another week in Chase Contemporary in Chelsea, which is where all the fancy galleries are. So the point of perspective is about here somewhere. So every building, every angle will lead to that point. That's the most important thing when painting these kind of or drawing these kind of pieces, is just to make sure you've got that point of perspective in the right place. I'm using rough. I think it's 300 pound Archer's watercolour paper. It's not the price, that's the weight of the paper. Somebody here with a brolly. Let's put them in there now. So there'd be a reflection, just part reflection of that person in the window. A yellow cab over here somewhere. Let's draw that in. I'll really make that quite loose and as if it's moving. So I think that's about it. And what I'm gonna do now is, I'll just show you this, just be easier. I'm just gonna drop a little, just a smidgen of ink, and then I'm gonna give the whole of it, whole of the picture, a kind of a tonal wash. So the more water, the thinner the ink will be, and I'm literally just going to give it a tone. There we go, so. And then I'm going to go over with watercolours. So I just really like the way that this ink is, sits on the paper. It's as if it was a watercolour, actually, but I don't know. I quite like the fact that it's like a grey, greyish tone. A little bit dark, but there we go. Let's match it up. You can thin it down. Good to leave the paper colour as well, so I'm not going to go over. It's just you can produce interest really quickly. I like to paint these sketches always within, it's kind of like an hour. and then I'll put in a reflection. I just want to a bigger brush here. So this will be the darkest part of the painting down here in the corner. So your eye will naturally go into the distance. Let's put that in. And then it gets lighter. The lightest part, this is going to be kept quite light here. So all of this will be light down the bottom. So it's the reflection of the sky. So that if the pavement is wet, which it is. While this paper's still wet, you can just add, like that's the windows, or the windowsills. If I put that in now, it will bleed and it will just make the detail a lot softer. So I'm just going to put the umbrella here. Let's put that in there. And reflection. And a couple more figures. So your eye goes down the street. Reflection. So this is the reflection, or you can't see it. There we go. This is the reflection of that person there. Okay, so that'll do for the moment. What I'll do is dry that, and then I'm going to put a watercolour wash over the top of it, and then I might do a little bit more ink work, and that will be it. But I'm just going to dry it, which obviously is going to be the noisy bit. Right, it's not perfectly dry, but it should be dry enough for me to work. So I'll just do a I'm just going to do a very muted sky. Sort of like a grey. It doesn't matter that I go over the Chrysler building there. Same this side. Gotta make sure that you don't forget to carry it right the way down, because if you didn't, then you'd have a hard edge, which doesn't look really very good. This tone that I've put on now will dry really light, so you'll hardly be able to notice it. This building here is like a bluey green. I've got this pearlescent watercolour here, which is a lovely bluey pearlescent. It's a lovely colour, and so let's put that in, do the reflection. And then this building here is blue. Let's put the reflection of that in here. The reflection of this building here. Just put that in. Actually forgot to draw this out this side, but I can put that in now. Doesn't matter. You can see how it's bled into the sky because that was still wet when I put this in. So that's a little mistake, but it doesn't matter. In the reflection here. I'm going to keep that dark there. That's the wall. This is the window. So there's a really bright that's going to run right down there. I'm not worried about that. There's a bright sign here and there's a few cars. Just going to put a little bit more of interesting colour here. And then ramp it up over here. On the reflection. So I don't know if you can see also, I've got some bronze and coppers in my palette. Which I'm gonna use here. Really sparkles that that copper. And then I'm gonna just so the darkest bit of this piece is down here. Let's put that in. I'll mix that up with a bit of copper. Put the the reflection in. So I'm going to put the taxi in now. I'm kind of matching this colour, so it's kind of more harmonised. And then put the reflection in. Just give the windows blue tint. So I'm just going to match up a little bit darker here, more. There's a bit more work on the figure. Bigger brush for this. I'm just gonna create a bit more of a surface. So I don't really want to do too much more now. It's I'm going to probably just add a little bit more pen work. I'll carry on for a little bit longer. See how we go. Put the street sign in. The lamps, and then so obviously the darker I make these areas here, the more that the car will stand out. You see how that works? It's kind of negative space. Right, I think I'll stop the live feed now. I'll work on it for a little bit longer, and I'll post it on Instagram in a little while. So I hope you've enjoyed that. It's been fun to paint that, and I'll show you how it looks in a little while. But thanks again for watching. Take care. Bye.